Now, Pittsburgh's best sports show is about to begin. Call us or tweet us. We got things to talk about on the Ireland Contracting Nightly Sports Call.
All right, thanks very much, Susan. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to another edition of the Ireland Contracting Nightly Sports Call on the Bordas & Bordas hotline, and you can reach out to us. All you have to do is call 412-575-2600. We're here to talk until 11 o'clock. Bob Pompiani, flanked by Ron Cook of the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette and Sports Radio 93.7 The Fan, and we'll begin with the Pirates, 4-0 after sweeping Detroit in Detroit. They come home today, and they get all they needed in the first inning in a rather bizarre game. Colin Moran worked Lance Lynn to a 3-2 pitch count after he had walked a couple, and he made him pay with one swing of the bat, five runs. Minnesota got four in the sixth. It looked like they may whittle their way back into it, but the bullpen closed it down. So, Ron, it's four games, and I always try to remind people that it's only four games. 2 years ago,
152 to go.
They were also
158 to go, excuse me.
And in 2 years ago, 4-0 turned into 79-83. So it's a long way to go, and they haven't even played the teams that they're going to have to deal with in their division. So having said that, a very nice beginning, and it's good to see the starting pitching do some pretty good things, including Trevor Williams, along with Chad Kuhl, and today Jameson Taillon.
Yeah, Taillon, five shutout innings into the sixth, kind of wilted a little bit. The bullpen barely hung on until the ninth, and Contos got in because Rivera wasn't available after both games yesterday. Contos did a 1-2-3. 4-0 is 4-0. All you can do is beat the team you're playing against, and they've done it. I give them credit. Polanco, I thought, had another good day. Four walks today, Bob. Had a double in the first inning before the grand slam by Moran, then four walks. Bell's hitting about .438. I like the lineup. I'm still not sold on the pitching at all. The bullpen, I'm really not sold on. But 4-0 is 4-0. Day off tomorrow. Hey, all you can say right now is the first-place Pirates.
Yep. Right behind them are the second-place Brewers at 3-1.
They got beat today.
I know.
Right?
Yes. But still, they're right.
So it's a first-place Pirates.
All right. So they are. And that's
good.
Come on. I'm glad to see
it. Enjoy it while it's here.
I'm just telling you. There were announced crowd today of 30,000.
30,000.
186, I think it was. And a lot of people, you know, you can blame a lot of different things on it. I just think it's the way this offseason went more than anything else. I think the weather may have impacted a potential walk-up. Whatever the case, it was the worst opening day crowd in PNC Park history. But you mentioned Polanco. I was encouraged by how he's swinging. To me, he was one of their big keys. He and Cervelli offensively were big keys to me. I needed to see Polanco now. It's a very short sample size. However, six runs batted in. He's on base all the time, Ron. That's a good thing. If Cervelli can continue to do that, and so far he has, all of a sudden now every other, you know, person in that lineup should benefit by those two guys getting red hot.
Well, I mean, I like the lineup, and Hurdle mentioned it after the game today. He said Jordy Mercer's your number eight hitter in the National League. That's a pretty good number eight hitter, and I agree. I'm still worried about the pitching. That's what it's always going to come down to. I don't think Nova was very good on opening day. He got through it a little bit. Williams with the six no-hit innings. Kuhl was okay. I thought Taillon today. Musgrove, who they got in the Cole trade they were counting on, he's on a disabled list again. So now they're back to Steven Brault. We'll see how far the pitching can carry him.
It's interesting that Colin Moran, starting third baseman, and the guy, one of the guys acquired in the Gerrit Cole trade, hits a grand slam in the home opener, only the third Pirate ever to do that behind Ralph Kiner and Roberto Clemente. Speaking of Gerrit Cole, in case you missed it yesterday, seven innings, 11 strikeouts. He got the win. He's their fourth starter. Their fifth starter is another name you'll be familiar with, in Charlie Morton. And tonight he goes six shutout innings, two hits, six strikeouts. They win. And I'm telling you, that is the best starting staff in all of baseball, one through five, with an extra guy who could be in any other rotation. When you have Verlander the entire season, when you have Gerrit Cole as your fourth, Charlie Morton, the renewed and reinvigorated Charlie Morton, Ron, that team should repeat. They're that loaded.
Yeah, I saw an interesting tweet from Jason Stark talking to a scout, and said that Cole has the best stuff in the National League. He predicted he would win the Cy Young this year. Wouldn't that be a kick in the gut for the Pirates if that's what happens? Now, the other guy that was traded away in the offseason, Andrew McCutchen, Bob, 1-for-16 so far.
Yep.
Another slow start for him. Had a double in the opening game, 0-for-4, 0-for-4, 0-for-4.
Thing is, San Francisco scored only two runs in a four-run series.
Games.
And yet they won two games because Joe Panic twice. Panic at the Disco hit a home run twice to win games 1-0 and 1-0. When we come back, we're going to talk about the plight of the Penguins, who lost last night and could be in jeopardy of falling out of the top three in the Metropolitan Division. We'll explain that and take your phone calls. You're watching another live edition of the Ireland Contracting Nightly Sports Call right here on Pittsburgh CW. The Ireland Contracting Nightly Sports Call is brought to you by Ireland Contracting, putting new roofs on Pittsburgh homes for over 25 years. Call Ireland Contracting at 1-800-NEW-ROOF.